وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك سيدي ابن القاسم يا رسول الله صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. في سوره ابراهيم الله سبحانه وتعالى has named the surah after him, Surah Ibrahim عليه السلام. If you have noticed that the last chapter of the surah, you cannot find Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام. He just increased his supplication to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ربنا وابعث فيهم رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياتي. O Allah, send among the Ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم a messenger from them. Recite your verses. Teach them the Quran and the book. And of course, before they were left astray. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, رَبَّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَاءِ. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for him to be able or to establish the prayer, not only him but his ummah. And then he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept his supplication. And then he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive his sin and the sins of his parents and for the believers. So Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he increased his dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is a prophet. One of the statements which I liked most, that the scholar says, be aware, one day the person can make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never accepting from him. Doesn't matter how righteous this person is. One day the person can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do not accept the supplication from this person. You can ask now, how is that? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيمٌ. Allah always accepts the supplication of people, yes. But if you just look at the Quran, you will find that even the prophets sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do not accept from them. Like Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, فَقَالَ رَبِّ النَّبِنِي مِنْ أَهْلِي وَإِنَّ وَعْدَكَ الْحَقُّ وَأَنْتَ أَحْكَمُ الْحَاكِمِينَ. When he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his son, when his son was wrong, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't accept that. قال يا نوح إنه ليس من أهلك إنه عمل غير صالح فلا تسألني ما ليس لك بعلم إني أعذك أن تكون من الجاهلين. So when Allah سبحانه وتعالى gets mad from the person, Allah سبحانه وتعالى can delay him many times. 1, 2, 3. Allah سبحانه وتعالى delayed the Pharaoh, فرعون, many times. But there is a time Allah سبحانه وتعالى has decreed his punishment against him. So the scholar says, be aware that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can delay the sinners 1 time, 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times. We do not know. But there is a time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send his punishment. Of course, it will happen. So always, when you're just doing something bad, be aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be mad at you. And return you back. And seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all of our sins and accept our prayers. Allahumma ameen.